It is a damp day in Foxborough, Massachusetts for this key AFC matchup, the Ravens and the Patriots. Between them, they've won three of the last four Super Bowls. Ravens trying to keep pace with Pittsburgh, stay two games back of the Steelers as Pittsburgh's already won today, while New England would like to win and also match the Steelers with that 10-1 record for the best mark in the AFC. Jim Nantz, Phil Simms, hello friends. Hope you've had a great Thanksgiving weekend. What about the conditions here, Phil, today?
Bad for the quarterbacks. Bad for anybody handling the football. Tom Brady and Kyle Bowler both came out. They warmed up. The wind, the rain. They put the gloves on, which I think will help them handle the football.
All right, and look at that weather just a little closer here. We're just east of Providence, west of Boston, southwest of Boston. And again, showers are rolling through here. They have all afternoon. You've been here for foul weather games, rain, snow. How does this field hold up?
Well, this field, I think, is very good when it's rainy like this. It's sandy. It's not fast. So if you rely on your speed to be the main part of your offense, well, it's not going to work. But it should hold up well to the cutting and running of the players.
Baltimore Ravens will receive the kick from Adam Vinatieri. The Ravens having won five of their last six games, while the Patriots have been victorious in 24 of their last 25. B.J. Sams, the rookie, wide open hole. And he's across the 30. Finally, they sling him down. It's Eugene Wilson bringing him down near the 35. Kyle Bowler is enjoying the most productive stretch of his young career. The second-year quarterback from Cal. The last two games has thrown four touchdowns overall. Two last week, two the week before. Both victories, no picks in those two games. A late scratch, Orlando Brown with a leg injury out. He was not able to go through the warm-up, so Ethan Brooks starts on the line. And Chester Taylor gets his third start of the year as Jamal Lewis is out today with an ankle sprain. They actually come out with a four receiver formation, and Bowler zings it over in the area of Randy Himes, incomplete. This New England defense, 25 straight games without allowing an opening drive touchdown, all the way back to the opener last year against Buffalo. Warren on the line. He had two sacks last week. McGinnis leads the team in that category with 8.5 sacks. And that patchwork secondary really held together by the wily veteran Rodney Harrison. So out of the shotgun, 2nd and 10 for Bowler in Baltimore. It from the sloppiest point on this field. Bowler gets it over to Kevin Johnson for a gain of 7. 3rd and 3 on
stop the run, so they don't have to cheat up and they can protect the new corners outside and maybe cover the wide receivers of the Ravens.
Vrabel threatening to blitz, now backs off on 3rd and 3. Dump it over to Alan Ricard, and he is short of the first as Eugene Wilson bounces him out of bounds. No gain.
Well, the Baltimore Ravens, known for their power running game. That shows you that first series, three straight passes, what they think of New England's defense. All those injuries, having trouble with the corner position. They come out and throw, but New England finds a way to get it done.
Kevin Falk deep. He has just in front of him a few steps Troy Brown. Nick Murphy, his second game as the punter for the Ravens, with Zastadil still out with a shoulder injury suffered 2 weeks ago. Flags are down as Falk runs it back to the 20. Will Demps on the hit, but there was a quick flag after a 52-yard boot. Scott Green is our referee.
Holding during the kick, number 30 of the receiving team, 10-yard penalty, first down.
So that'll back up the Patriots near the 10-yard line. In fact, we'll mark it closer to the 5. We welcome everybody to Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, Massachusetts. Jim Nantz, Phil Simms, Bonnie Bernstein. We're just underway. The Ravens took the opening kick. 3 plays and out. And after a punt and a penalty on the Patriots, we're ready for New England's first snap of the game from their own 5. Corey Dillon, 2 yards shy of 1,000. He's got his 1,000-yard season. And a run of 5 yards behind Matt Light. Hold on a minute. We have a flag. Let's not give him the 1,000 yet. Scott Green's crew on hand here for this matchup of the 9-1 Patriots, the 7-3 Ravens.
As I watch this game, for the quarterbacks, I think the rain is not the big story. It's the wind, which you will hear.
After the play, unnecessary roughness, number 82. Half the distance to the goal. It is second down.
So they'll count the down. Dylan becomes, well, the fastest back in Patriot history to reach 1,000 yards in a season. He missed one entire game, the only loss for the Patriots this year at Pittsburgh, getting his 1,000 in his 10th game dressed. From the end zone, Brady rifles incomplete in double coverage. Looking for Daniel Graham down the middle. Daniel Graham had a big game on Monday night in the win at Kansas City. Third down on the way. I'd like to welcome the audience that saw the Bengals outscore Cleveland 58-48 in what is the second highest scoring game that did not go to overtime. Second highest scoring game in NFL history. Only topped by the Redskins and Giants back in 1966. Patriots first possession. Third down from the 5. And Brady signals for a timeout, trying to beat the down clock. I'd like to welcome the audience that saw the Chargers win it over Kansas City on a Kading field goal, 34-31, as the Chargers go to 8-3 on the season. Another big day for Drew Brees.
Well, everybody has a big day when they play the Kansas City Chiefs, and Drew Brees having a big year just followed that up. You know, believe it or not, sometimes there's a little pressure when you're a quarterback and you play a bad defense, because you go, am I going to be the first guy that's not going to rip it up? That wasn't the case for San Diego today.
For those just joining us who saw that Charger Chief game, this is New England's first possession of the game. They face third and long from the 3-yard line. Brady fires it out of the end zone. Down the field, he's got David Patton at the 40. 38 yards.
First thing you got to say is Tom Brady buys the extra time in the pocket, and David Patton getting down the field. Ed Reed thinks he has the football, underestimates the strength of Tom Brady's arm as he rifled it down the field for a big first down early in this game.
Coming on third and 12. Corey Dillon, the single back. And he'll take the toss. Try the right side, and he's able to make an easy five behind Stephen Neal. Tom Brady, when we spoke to him, Phil, he was so fired up about this matchup.
Yeah, he wanted to see how he was going to match up against his good defense.
We've already seen Dylan run behind Matt Light on the left side of that Patriot line. And Dylan, with his first carry of this game, went over 1,000 on the season. His 7,000-yard season in his career, his first 6 with the Bengals. Second down. And 5. Looking for Troy Brown. And Chad Williams was right there to make sure that the reception or attempt was influenced. This Ravens defense, the stingiest in the NFL, giving up only 14 points a game. Everyone in the league started to take note of the third-year lineman, Anthony Weaver, and the second-year linebacker, Terrell Suggs, who leads the team in sacks. And Ed Reed, well, put it in the words of Bill Belichick, he thinks he's the defensive MVP in the NFL this year.
Yeah, a lot of people around the league know that he is playing better than anybody on the defensive side.
Third and 5 for New England on its first possession. Back over on the right side again, was attempting to hook up with Troy Brown. And Chad Williams makes a play in the backfield on the quarterback.
Well, this Baltimore defense, what they do, they're a lot like New England. They will confuse you because they play so many linebackers and defensive backs, so you have trouble. Who's who? Am I blocking this guy or that guy? So that time, Chad Williams comes in unblocked and straight to Tom Brady.
Josh Miller in to punt on fourth and five. So the Patriots, they were pinned back at their own two on third and 12. Able to gain some field position in this chess match. Sams was the deep back, but will not have a play on this kick as it's off the side of the foot. They'll mark it near the 30. Call it the 27. We'll see Baltimore on the field for the second time.
I'm only happy when it rains.
You're only happy when it rains. You're happy right now as Brian Billick's team comes to the line for the second time in this game. Three and out on their first possession. Two backs, Rickard and Chester Taylor, lined up in the eye on first down for Kyle Bowler. He's got Taylor at the 30, 35, and about a yard shy of the first. Ted Johnson on the hit, and Chester Taylor getting his third start in place of Jamal Lewis, who's out with an ankle injury. Taylor had to go the bulk of the way against Dallas last week. He scored a touchdown on the win over the Cowboys as Jamal Lewis was injured on his second carry of the game. What about Taylor?
Well, Travis Taylor is different from Jamal Lewis, Jim. The fact is, Travis Taylor's going to go to the outside a lot more than Jamal Lewis.
It is second down and one. It for the first down.
Well, this defense for the Patriots, not afraid to take chances and do it differently if they have to. Now they have Rodney Harrison at corner, and they have moved a linebacker, Don Davis, number 51. Looks kind of strange playing deep in the middle of the field. He is playing safety.
Travis Taylor picks up the first down with the catch, and Don Davis is a 9-year player out of Kansas who has been playing some safety the last three games, again with his patchwork secondary. First down, Ravens. It's Taylor running right into Ty Warren for no gain. And we have Bonnie Bernstein on the sidelines. Bonnie?
Hey there, Jim. Well, there's a pretty decent chance that the AFC's road to the Super Bowl will go through New England. And that was a big point of emphasis for Brian Billick with the Ravens this week. He reminded them about the 2000 season when Baltimore went down to Tennessee, beat the Titans for the first time ever in the Coliseum, and then went and did it again in the playoffs and rode to the Super Bowl. He said, our road mentality has to start now. It's time to stake our ground.
Second and 10, the lanky rookie Clarence Moore is in at wide receiver. And plowing ahead, it's Taylor for about five. Third and five coming up near midfield.
You know, Brian Billick, like Bonnie Bernstein said, trying to look ahead because he's being realistic. He looks at the Pittsburgh Steelers. They won again today. He looks at the New England Patriots. He sees their record, and he knows to have success in the playoffs that you might have to go to both places to win. And so come up here today, play well, give yourself some confidence in case you have to do it again in the playoffs.
Patriots have brought in Troy Brown on defense on third and five for the Ravens. Bowler tucks it under, now a run with it. What a nifty move, and he has the first down. Powered ahead for six. Richard Seymour had him for a moment.
One thing you don't see a lot of, even though people talk a lot about it, Kyle Bowler, pretty good athlete, runs pretty fast, but he doesn't move around as much as he probably should. But that time, nobody opened down the field, and he just gets away from Richard Seymour, a defensive tackle who can run. Just changing in front of everybody's eyes. The offense is getting healthy. They're throwing the football more. He's feeling better and playing a lot better.
On first down, he looks left side, and right on that note, he gets intercepted by Randall Gay. Gay looking for the left side, and flags are thrown as Clarence Moore brings the pick play to a halt at the 49 of New England.
Well, that was the old Jinx-em like Jim Nance award on that throw.
The announcer Hex award.
Yeah, I hear you. But the one thing Matt Kavanaugh, the offensive coordinator, said to Kyle Bowler, don't stare at receivers.
After the interception, personal foul, low block, 44, 15-yard penalty, 50.
Well, Bowler picked somewhere in the mix. Dan Wilcox of the Ravens called for an infraction, so the Patriots will have the ball at the 36 of Baltimore when we come back. Kyle Bowler had not been picked in over 120 attempts. He had the second longest streak going in the league, second only to Drew Brees, who went without an interception today and is up to 193 passes now without an interception. And with the penalty added on, New England and Brady begin from the 36 of the Ravens. With Dillon in the backfield. Dillon makes one stutter step move on Demps to get outside. And picks up a yard. What did you see on the pick?
Well, you have to be careful. Kyle Bowler, be careful. Watch Randall Gay. He's going to cover Terry Jones out in the flat. He sees Kyle Bowler looking at the receiver. He falls off of his guy, gets right in the lane, and makes the interception. And watch Kyle Bowler as he drops back. He gets stuck looking down the field. He waits a little too long, and that's what Randall Gay saw. Again, the eyes of the quarterback falls right off the receiver. Nice shot there. Almost from the eyes of the defensive back.
We'll call it second and eight. Randall Gay, the rookie from LSU, undrafted, now with two picks on the season. As Dillon gains just a yard. Third and seven coming. And how about the Sims
receivers? He would have a hard time matching up against them.
Here's Bill Belichick, who was raised some 30 miles outside of Baltimore in Annapolis, Maryland. Third and seven for the Patriots, coming from now the sloppiest, most problematic portion of the field. Rest of it's in good shape. Brady has to unload as the pressure was coming in from Will Demps. Safety blitz.
Tom Brady's got to feel like he's at practice against his team. He drops back, and there are people moving everywhere. And look, somebody is coming free. Will Demps. I don't know. He looks at his glove. Didn't like it. Looks like it's got a, might have tore it.
Looks like it ripped apart a little bit, right in the thumb area. So instead of a, say, 52-yard field goal try.
Look at all the mud that's on the football.
Josh Miller in, punting for the second time. First one was crooked, some 28 yards of travel. And this is not what they called for either. Touchback, and the Patriots do not take advantage of the pick. Baltimore ball at the 20. We're back in Foxborough, and we remind you, you can log on to NFL.com and see what Phil Sims and Boomer Esiason and Shannon Sharp and the team of analysts have to say each week about the games. It's all on NFL.com or NFL on AOL. Baltimore's third possession of this first quarter. And Bowler throws it behind Travis Taylor. So you should tell everybody when the conditions are like this, we're seeing the players bring out the glove, something that you really kind of started in the league.
Yeah, I tried it back when I, in 1985, in a playoff game against Chicago Bears. I said, there's no way I'm going to wear any gloves. And I went out to warm up. It was about 30 below. I said, where are those gloves? Let me put them on. But they've gotten so much better. The quality that Tom Brady has worn them many times in games that I thought there's no reason to do it, that they can control the football just much better.
That's Chester Taylor up to the 25, third and five coming up. Now, Kyle Bowler does not have much experience playing in bad weather. We asked him. He's only played in one rain game in his high school, college, or pro career. When he was at Cal, he played 1 year in the rain up at Oregon. Artificial grass up there, so this is the first rain/mud game of his career.
Matt Kavanaugh, the offensive coordinator, asked him about it coming up here, thinking it might rain, and he was like, what? You've only played once when it rains? But he does have big hands, so it should not be that big of a factor for him.
Third and five, hard running by Taylor, but he won't get to the goal. The goal being the 30-yard line for the first. Only out to the 27 as Earthwind Moreland helps shut him down along with Vrabel and the rest of that Patriot defense.
Patriots really shuffling in a lot of different defensive players, trying to give them a lot of looks because they know they're weak in the secondary. And also, they look fresh. Bill Belichick, the hard-driving, tough coach, took it really easy on the guys this week, knowing that who he was playing, they were going to need all the speed and toughness they could get.
Nick Murphy, second punt of the game. The first one traveled more than 50 yards. This is another good one, but low and returnable by Kevin Falk. And he is dragged down by Demps at the 31. Another 50-yard boot. We'll see the Patriots' third possession. No score here in Foxborough. With the family.
Yeah, they make you feel good.
Absolutely. From the 31, Brady fakes to Dillon. Now looking right side and over the head of Deion Branch. Branch, who returned on Monday night after missing seven games with a knee injury. In talking to Tom Brady, he, like everyone else, was just amazed at how much Branch could accomplish with only 2 days of practice after being out for some 2 months.
What did Tom Brady say? He was back for 2 days of practice. I was like, it's like he's never been away. And when you watch this New England offense, Deion Branch brings that extra little bit of speed that they need, the big play. And don't forget now, he takes other receivers, moves them down the lineup, and makes them more productive, too.
Back to Branch on second and 10, and he has his first reception of the game. He caught six in that win at Kansas City Monday night for over 100 yards and a touchdown.
Again, we just talked about it. You have to respect him on the outside just because of the speed and awfully tough, too. That time, Raymond Walls, backup corner, is in there because Chris McAllister has gone out for the Baltimore defense, their star defensive back.
Got Richard Seymour in the backfield as a fullback. Lined up in front of Corey Dillon on third and one. Dillon will run behind Seymour, and Dillon's second effort might have been enough for the first. Thomas hit him short of the first, but Dillon was able to spin out of it a little bit and maybe lean enough to get the necessary yardage. They'll bring out the chains.
Richard Seymour is the fullback. He can't find anybody to hit because to the outside, Daniel Graham loses his man, who's Adalys Thomas, comes inside and makes the tackle. But you know why he couldn't find anybody to hit, though? Because they say, wait, get out of the way. The big man's coming. Because what an athlete. A defensive tackle, usually they're overweight. Richard Seymour can play tackle. He can play in. He's a fullback. And he can run for a big person. And what I like best about him all, which I've noticed more this year than ever before, he's got a little bit of that, what's the word, Jim?
Panache.
No.
Something about.
He's a little edgy the field. On the field. You know, he might walk by you and push you, let you know that he's just. There's a term in football, it's got a little rat in him. You know, you need a little bit of that in your football team. You don't want all angels. You want some guys that are looking for a little action out there. Kind of like you. You know, you got an edge to you.
That's what you like. First and 10. And they go back to Dillon up the middle for 4 yards. Seymour, though, can really get running downhill. He had a fumble return in the Buffalo game at Buffalo earlier this season. Longest fumble return in Patriot history. So he, like everybody else here on this Patriot team, is ready for action, whether it's on offense, defense.
Yeah.
Ways they find to make everyone versatile.
Yeah, and you know what's going to happen? Next year in the National Football League, we're going to see more teams with 4, 5, 6 guys who play dual roles because use your talent. Get them more involved.
Starting to work Dillon. Second down and 5, and he bangs bodies with Ed Reed. And Reed with a good head, enough to keep Dillon a yard shy of the first.
Yeah, you talk about Corey Dillon. He has come to this football team. Look at the numbers from 2003 to 2004 for this New England rush offense. It's changed really everything. Now they're a power running football team, and then Tom Brady fakes it and they rip it down the field with the throws. And I've talked to many defensive coordinators who play the Patriots. They don't like this. They used to like to play that little short passing game and see if they can nickel dime it down the field. Now it's fake it. When they throw it deep.
Third and one, and they bring in a five receiver package with Dillon out, and Brady spreads them out enough to find the open gap and run behind Copen and Neal for the first down.
Well, Charlie Weiss, he's got all the angles. You never know what he's going to do. But Tom Brady comes in with five wide receivers, and there's nobody inside. You see all the receivers. There's five. And the Ravens line up to play pass. Tom Brady, that running threat, picks up a yard.
Kevin Faulk is the single back. First down for the Patriots. Second time they've entered Baltimore territory.
Ed Hardwell came on late. Tom Brady stopped to let him get out there because he was confused.
Brady across the middle, and Deion Branch had Ray Lewis defending.
The Patriot wide receivers, you know what? They're getting open down the field. The problem is Tom Brady is not getting that extra half second to set his feet and throw it. That time, Terrell Suggs, the second time he's been in the backfield to keep Tom Brady from getting a long pass completed down the field.
Patriots got as far as the Ravens 34 on their previous series, then had the punt. It's second down and 10. They have scored first in 18 straight games, New England. Pressure on Brady. Gets the pass away somehow. It's Daniel Graham at the 25. Douglas was in the face of the quarterback, actually had him by the ankles, and Brady stood strong and picks up 22 yards.
There's two ways to play a defense. Daniel Graham going to go all the way across the field. When your defensive backfield is beat up and shorthanded, you either play very conservative and drop everybody back in cover, or you blitz the quarterback so he doesn't have very long to throw it down the field. That time, enough protection, good movement by Tom Brady, and an excellent route by Daniel Graham gets him wide open.
At the 25 of Baltimore, David Gibbons to the right. Brady looks his way, now flings it left. It's Deion Branch dancing around and out of bounds near the 10. First they'll say he stepped out actually back at the 13.
What it looks like so far, if you protect the quarterback, the Patriots think they could get somebody open down the field. Adalis Thomas, a big, big linebacker like Willie McGinnis, is not going to be that good out in space. Deion Branch gets by him quite easily.
Four receivers, make it five as Graham is actually lined up. In the slot to the right on first and 10. And that pass almost picked off by Ed Reed. Why is it every time you're talking about the Patriots, there's some sort of incredible streak involved, whether it's their 21-game win streak, scoring first, whatever it might be?
I'll tell you why. All that just says how good they are. Every game we do, you got numbers. I go, really?
It is. It's mind-blowing.
It is. And 21 victories in a row. You know, the way they do it, so many close games. First one to score, what did you say, 15 times in a row?
15 regular season, 18 overall.
That's incredible.
In fact, if they score here to make it 19 straight, they would break the all-time record in NFL history. They score first. Gibbons, he is down at the 8, third down on the way. The 15 consecutive regular season game scoring first ties the 78 Miami Dolphins for the longest streak in NFL history. And again, they recognize only regular season streaks in the NFL official record book.
You know, to get off to a good start, of course, confidence comes with it. You get the other team thinking they're behind. You dictate tempo. You dictate play calling. Situations, so important. All that goes hand in hand, and again, tells us why they won 21 in a row.
I tell you, they're going to let the quarter expire, maybe because if they fail on third down, the other end of the field will be far easier to kick. This is messy end. They're leaving. Into the quarter, no score.
Well, Jim Nance, I think you're right. When you look at this end of the field, footing for the quarterback and the kicker, because we have third down. Look how it's worn out. And then the other end, look at this. Beautiful grass. Looks like it. Well, there we go. You moved the shot on me. That it's good footing. And in case they do have to punt after third field goal attempt after third down, going to be a lot easier for Adam Vinatieri.
First play of the second quarter. Third down and five. Brady play action. In the pocket, now chased out and sacked. It's Douglas. He made a run at him earlier on this series. This time he got him.
Marcus Douglas gets the sack coming from the outside, but the coverage down the field. Tom Brady, one, moving, looks to another guy. He's looking everywhere. They're all covered. Good job by the Baltimore secondary.
To bring out Adam Vinatieri, he's only missed one kick all year. Another great season, 25 of 26. On the season, this is a 28-yard try.
Probably the greatest clutch kicker in the history of the NFL.
He's got another one, and the Patriots score first. Again, they have the record. 16 straight regular season games scoring first.
Well, I'll tell you why the Baltimore Ravens are number one in scoring defense. Watch as they're down in the red zone. Troy Brown covered inside, all three receivers covered. Excellent job of recognizing a route, getting around the receiver, and nowhere for Tom Brady to throw the football.
Vinatieri's kick. Sam's at the four. And a couple of Patriots over there, including Patrick Pass and Gerard Cherry. Another flag on special teams. They break now. They had shared it, the record, with the 78 Dolphins.
Block in the back, number 57, 10-yard penalty, first down.
That was at 15. Now they have it at 16.
You didn't bring this one up to Bill Belichick the other day. I like, you know, he loves to talk to you about streaks.
I'm not talking about streaks with him anymore, but he has another one. Getting breezy here in Foxborough. We remind you, tomorrow Everybody Loves Raymond, a whole new episode. For years, Raymond has always been his mother's favorite, but now Ray's brother is suddenly the number one son. What caused this? Find out tomorrow on Everybody Loves Raymond.
It's got to be money.
Is that what it is?
I think
Raymond's got a little bit. On first down for the Ravens, they've managed now with that carry only 42 total yards in the game as Taylor picks up four. Punted twice, and Bowler got picked on the second series.
And you know, just talking to the Ravens, the head coach, the quarterback, Matt Cavanaugh, the offensive coordinator, yeah, they want to get after these corners. It's a great thought. The question is, can you get it done? New England knows that.
Play action, Bowler across the middle to Wilcox. And he is taken down by Johnson and Davis after a gain of 20 out to the 35.
What a throw by Kyle Bowler. When Dan Wilcox is in the game, remember, if they're going to throw it, they're usually going to throw it his way. He's the receiving tight end. Way to load it up quick and get rid of it. And we talked about that. Sit on that back foot, throw it. Excellent technique. And Kyle Bowler just continues to improve.
Ravens without the services of Todd Heap again this week. It's Taylor, and met at the line. Stood up for no gain. Well, Bowler again has been picked in the early action, but the last 2 weeks you saw significant improvement in Kyle Bowler.
Well, I've really seen it all year long, even early in the season when he was having troubles with numbers. And I hope I'm not that shallow where I'm just going to judge him on his numbers, but he's been making good decisions all year long, and he's just controlling the football. And I think that's come with time. He's changed a bit. Jim Fossil's changed him some of his, with some of his techniques. They call better plays to get him in the flow of the offense, and that's the reason the numbers are better.
He dumps it over to Taylor on second and 10. It was a flag thrown. It's going to be on Alan Rickard, who was trying to throw a clearing block. And it was really after Taylor had already moved past the first down marker.
Yeah, he hit Eugene
Holding.
Wilson.
Number 39, 10-yard penalty, still second down.
It looked like a good block to me. Alan Rickard had a good angle. Here it comes. Okay, now, and I tell you what, that was some really quick thinking and great acting by Eugene Wilson. don't you think?
Didn't see a whole lot of hold there.
Nope, I think it's just the way it looks. And, you know, you think about it, how it looks to the officials on the field. What else do they have to go by? It looked like a hold. Just throw it down there.
Jamel White has come into the Ravens backfield, just signed this week. Number 30. His first action as a Raven, and he'll touch it right away for no gain, maybe a yard. McGinnis on the hit. We'll give him one. Third and nine coming up. Let's go back down to Bonnie.
Well, Jim, if you look at Kyle Bowler's numbers earlier in the season, he was really only getting the ball 18, 19 times a game. The last four games, that number's been jacked up to around 30. And he talked to us about how much more comfortable he feels in this offense. He says, I don't feel rushed. The game is finally slowing down. The other thing that's helped is he's really gotten a lot of reps with Dan Wilcox and Darnell Dinkins and Clarence Moore. Young guys who, without the injuries to Todd Heap and Travis Taylor, wouldn't be getting a lot of time, and now he's quickly building that chemistry with them.
All right, Bonnie, you saw Troy Brown coming into the secondary on third. We'll call it seven. To come after Bowler. Pass is short of Moore. Bowler got decked, and again, fourth possession. And the Ravens will have to punt it away.
And it's a good thing that throw was short. Eugene Wilson was coming underneath the receiver for the interception. He read the route properly, but Roosevelt Colvin blitzing from the outside made Kyle Bowler throw the football short.
Nick Murphy has come on now for the second game, replacing Dave Zastadil, who injured a shoulder in the Jet game 2 weeks ago. He's hit a couple of 50-yard punts. This one going out of bounds sideways. Hits in the field of play. There is another flag.
This is one of those days. Weather, the opposing team's defense, if you're a quarterback, you just go, it's going to be rough. Going to have some ugly stats when this game ends.
During the kick, holding, 53, receiving team. Penalty will be enforced from the end of the kick. First down.
We have 11:18 to go in the second quarter. Muddy conditions at Foxborough, and the Patriots lead it on a Vinatieri field goal. We're back in New England, and coming up, the Nextel Halftime Report with Greg and Dan and Shannon and Boomer, all the latest NFL scores and highlights. And it's all coming up on the Nextel Halftime Report.
Peyton Manning in there today, did an excellent job. Let's see, he can do it all.
So did Archie previous days.
I'm starting to dislike Peyton a little now. Playing well, touchdowns, young.
Brady over to Gibbons. Shakes off one tackle, gets out to the 20 for only 3 yards. Suggs drags him down.
Well, let's watch what Tom Brady has done so far today. He has hit a couple of nice passes down the field. The weather, the pressure, put it all together, and you are going to be off target as a quarterback. Look at it. They're all over him as he gets ready to throw the football, and a little mud got on his hand and on that glove. In case you're wondering out there, if you're a quarterback, it gets bad weather. Tom Brady is wearing some gloves that are awesome in bad weather.
Second down and seven. And over in the area of Dillon, but Ed Reed was blitzing the quarterback. What about those gloves? What are they? Are they different than bowlers?
It's like synthetic. It's almost like a rubber. That's why it's working. So he came out without gloves on and said, the heck with that. And he put these on. Doug Flutie. You know, I'm not going to say who makes them. I don't even really know. But Doug Flutie used to wear them when he was with the Buffalo Bills. And I saw him play twice in pouring rain. And he threw the football better than I've ever seen him throw it. So Tom Brady researched it and found them.
Are bowlers just like that?
Bowler has a whole different kind on it. Well, he's younger. He doesn't know all the tricks yet.
On third and seven, they were blitzing. And the pass was thrown at David Patton.
And I'm sure Kyle Bowler's mom or dad, if somebody's watching it, so you got to tell him to get rid of the ones you got on and go get the ones Tom Brady has.
Maybe they'll send their son a pair of gloves for Christmas.
There you go.
But maybe even earlier. We might need them before that.
David Patton limping off the field after that last throw.
Got hit by Corey Fuller as he attempted to make the reception. Sam's the return man, has run two punts back for touchdowns this in his rookie year. And from the 40, he falls forward near midfield. So excellent starting position coming up for Kyle Bowler and Baltimore. Down 3-0, second quarter. Congratulations to the Philadelphia Eagles, the first team to clinch a playoff berth. And you can find all the latest playoff scenarios with predictions and analysis from Sportsline's experts at CBSSportsline.com. Ravens start this series at midfield. And Bowler's running out with it and sliding to the Patriots 46. During that timeout, Bill Belichick and Charlie Weiss had a little summit with Tom Brady.
Got Tom Brady over there because this Baltimore defense is giving them some looks that are causing problems. And remember, Bill Belichick, defensive coach, he's going over and say, look, here's what they're doing, and maybe helping them out to help them figure out what to do the next time they get the football.
And second and five, it's back to Taylor. And look at that piece of running. Inside of the 40 for a first down.
Chester Taylor, he's not Jamal Lewis, not saying that, but he's not faint of heart either. He'll stick it up in there and try to get some tough yards and a little quicker maybe. And like we said early, he's willing to take the ball off the tackles, take it outside, and get some extra yards when it's there.
His longest run of the game with 9 yards on that last carry. Third year back from Toledo. First down for Bowler. Looking down the field to Travis Taylor and well defended by Eugene Wilson. Wilson normally a free safety but has been playing the corner position an awful lot today.
Well, you talked about it, Jim. Listen, everybody's got dual roles in this team. A little double move by Travis Taylor. Nice job by Eugene Wilson. You know, these defensive backs now in the NFL, they know how to read so well what's real and what's not. He doesn't go for the fake, and he is all over the long throw by Kyle Bowler.
Bowler told us when he was preparing for the draft, he worked out with Eugene Wilson, and he thought maybe he could get a size advantage in a matchup today. It's Taylor on second and 10. And he squirts down to about the 34 behind Ethan Brooks, who starts at right tackle today in place of Orlando Brown.
We talk about this Baltimore offense. They run the ball. Look at that. Fourth highest in the NFL.
I actually would have thought it might even be higher than that.
Well, it's really changed, Jim, like you talked about the last 4 weeks. Kyle Bowler getting throws up into the 30s. So that's driven that percentage way down.
An even split so far. Third and six. Harold Morrow has come in. There's a running back for the Ravens. Randy Hines, what a play by Rodney Harrison. Now, decision for Brian Billick. Will he attempt the tying field goal with Stover? He's going to punt it instead, it looks like.
I would punt it too. In a game like this, with this field, the way your defense is playing, it's raining, it's windy. Make them get it out there, they're into the field. You're hoping to get the ball back about midfield if you stop them.
Nice play by Rodney Harrison, competing in his 150th NFL game.
One of the best tacklers in the league, Rodney Harrison.
Murphy takes something off this one. Kevin Falk, basket catch at the 10-yard line. Rodney Harrison, what a pickup he was a year ago. Forces the Ravens to punt. Wow. They skipped right past you.
Smart parents is probably one of the gifts.
Right by you and had to go back 200 years.
Uh-huh.
From the 11, Brady on first down. It's Corey Dillon ridden down after a gain of 5.
I expect this Patriots offense to settle down now and go back to running the football. And because they've tried some 5 wide receivers, they've tried a few little different looks, and the Baltimore Ravens have the answers. But when you line up, it just becomes more about our talent against yours, not so much the thought process or the brain power.
Past the midway point of the second quarter, only a 28-yard field goal by Adam Vinatieri. Call it second and 6. And Dillon, about a yard shy of the first, running into Kelly Gregg.
Boy, look at this side of the field. We talked about it, Jim. You showed it. It is some treacherous footing. Look at the offensive linemen slipping a little as they try to take off. But remember, the defensive linemen have a hard time, too, digging in. Everybody always says that the offense always has an edge. And I look, I've played on offense in a lot of those bad games. I never found it to be that much of an edge.
They've got an
bad
edge.
Bad footing is bad footing.
They brought back in that edge you talked about earlier with Richard Seymour. Third and one. And Dylan able to squeeze through a small seam for the first down.
Richard Seymour just can't find anybody to hit.
Yeah, he was looking again.
He was looking. We know he's not afraid to, that's for sure.
So Seymour steps back out. He's been in on two third and one situations. Both times, Dylan able to do the work without a whole lot of room to pick up the first down.
Now that you've run it three straight times, you got a little power going. Play action passes will become easier.
It's Dylan outside. Dylan with room. Dylan out of bounds at the 25. Gary Baxter shut down the outside.
Well, you know, we talked about it early, Jim. Bill Belichick, when we talked to him on Friday, took it easy all week. Basically just had walkthroughs with his football team. They didn't even practice hard. They played on Monday night. It's getting late in the year. And as he said, he's going soft in his old age, I guess, too. But he knew what kind of game this was going to be. You can't be finesse against the Baltimore Ravens.
And that's good for the first down to David Givens. There is a flag.
You're going to win this game against the Ravens because you out-hit them and you're willing just to slug it out with them.
There's no foul on the play.
So third catch for Givens, and it's going to be enough for the first down. Coach Belichick talking about tapering back in practice this week. It had nothing to do with the holiday. Hey, guys, go home. Have a good time.
Yeah.
No, it had to be more about trying to have his team, as he said it, fresh and ready to go.
Yeah, that's right.
You got to meet force with force.
There's no other way. And you know, when you're in a ring with a brawler in boxing, you can't dance around and tap him. You got to get in there and brawl with him.
I'm actually going to just double check on the measurement. Givens looked to be past the necessary yardage, but yeah, they stretch it out by a couple of chain links. New set of downs for the Patriots. And patriotic meeting indeed. Army and Navy is coming up next Saturday on CBS. One of the great festivals in all of sport. Army and Navy. The Home Depot College Football on CBS.
Navy had an outstanding season so far. Bobby Ross at Army has turned it around. Got them playing well. And boy, this rivalry is going to get hot in the next few years.
Been fortunate enough to be at three Army-Navy games. And I tell you, they're all special. As Brady across the middle, complete with a flag down back to Givens.
Holding, number 33, the offense. 10 yards penalty, still first down.
So erase the reception. Kevin Falk flagged for that.
I think Kevin Falk was blocking Ray Lewis. The Ravens, when they get spread out, they said, to heck with it, we're going to come after you. And he's actually blocking Will Demps, number 47, coming off the side this time. Gets down. Oh, look at the nice jersey pull. Will Demps gets by him, and it was a good hold because otherwise he's going to hit Tom Brady and maybe cause a fumble.
Brady back there in the pocket slipping and sliding in the mud. First down and 20.
49 is the Mikey, just said.
All kinds of time, and Brady way downfield, incomplete. Under through just by a little bit, David Patton.
When I just said Tom Brady, when he stops, and we could hear it on the audio that time, 49 is the mic, what he is telling is the offensive line, you have to block 49 if he comes on a blitz. Tom Brady, he knows if you're a defensive back, look at the protection. If you're not looking at him, he can throw it, and the receiver can react to the throw, and the defensive back doesn't, just threw it a little short that time.
Championship banners from Super Bowl 36 and 38. Ravens won Super Bowl 35. Second down 20, fake right, go left. It's Daniel Graham. And what a play by Ed Reed. He never misses.
That was some play. So quick. He reacts to passes down the field. It looks like a wonderful screen. Nice fake by Tom Brady. Baxter misses a tackle. There's a blocker out front. Can't get to Ed Reed.
How about the appreciation you could hear in the voice of Tom Brady and Bill Belichick this week when talking about Ed Reed?
Tom Brady said something. The Jets threw the halfback pass a couple weeks ago. He says you could throw that pass 100 times against Ed Reed. He is not going to get out of position once. What a compliment.
Third and 18, left side. It's Deion Branch. And he is denied the first down by Raymond Walls. He also added as a footnote, if Jordan had not launched the pass on the halfback option, he says, I guarantee you that Ed Reed would have cut up and made the tackle.
That's right.
He's everywhere he has to be.
I know. The Patriots were hoping he wouldn't stand back in the middle of the field and just run to the football.
And Ed Reed stays on the field for special teams. He's always asked to be on special teams, as he told us this season. Every play counts. It's like a chess match. Now he described it. He's lined up on that right side as Josh Miller's in to punt.
Oh, another shank.
Oof.
Wow.
Josh Miller has averaged over 45 yards a punt on the season. Best in the AFC, but he has struggled today. That went only 16 yards with 3 minutes to go in the half. Ball deflected at the line.
You know, this must be tough for Kyle Bowler. He's a quarterback. He gets up underneath the center and he goes, wait, 51 is playing safety. And this time he is actually throwing to the tight end coming across. Vince Wilfork knocks the football down. And Don Davis, the safety, was coming up. Linebacker slash safety is coming up for the coverage.
Second and 10. Bowler in Baltimore shut out last week in the first half by Dallas. As Taylor shows some quickness, running behind Rickard for 6 yards. They were shut out in the first half by the Cowboys and then put up 30 in the second half in the win.
Yeah, the Ravens, though, let me tell you, Brian Billick, he knows his football team. He knows how to play. They don't panic. They are one of the best in the league besides the Patriots. These two, they manage football games tremendously well. So they don't panic, and they're going to just wait. Even if they don't score, it doesn't hurt their feelings. They don't worry. They don't rush it. They just hang in there and try to get it done at the end.
Romeo Crennel brings in Troy Brown on 3rd-and-4. Harrison was rushing the quarterback and certainly affected the flight of that pass intended for Travis Taylor. Bowler took the hit from Rodney Harrison.
Little different look this time. Rodney Harrison comes from the outside. Just a couple little things. One, he's lined up on the receiver. He hit the receiver first, so he can't get down the field as quick. And he hit Kyle Bowler pretty good that time. And Kyle Bowler didn't like the way those gloves were treating him, so he is now taking them off.
Reaching the two-minute warning, low snap, fielded nicely. And the kick into the end zone. Nick Murphy. With 2:07 to go, second quarter. And again, coming up, the Nextel Halftime Report with Greg and Dan and Shannon and Boomer, all the latest scores and highlights. And it's all coming up on the Nextel Halftime Report. It sure was good to see Leslie Visser back in the studio, back in the mix today on the NFL Today. Been recovering during the fall from a recent hip operation. Great to have our wonderful teammate back. Talking about how do you condense highlights of the Cincinnati-Cleveland game into 30 seconds or so.
Yeah, pretty amazing. You know, the Bengals defense been playing better of late. The Cleveland Browns defense, it's played pretty much well all year long. So I'm expecting a 10-3 game, pretty boring, and look what happens. Once it gets going sometimes when it opens up, it just keeps going.
9 punts, 11 first downs in this game total. Kelly Holcomb, by the way, in that game for the Browns, throws 5 touchdowns and loses. Bad snap, and Brady wisely just falls on it.
In the mud. Look at the mud on the football.
So the center sticks it on the ground, gets slippery, gets away from him, and it's a low snap. And it catches Tom Brady a little bit by surprise almost.
So that brings us to the two-minute warning. New England with the field goal, that's all, leading 3-0. Late in the half, two-minute warning, and Stover's already out, kind of getting ready for a possible field goal. I might remind you that it's still second down for New England, and yes, the Ravens are in position here to get the football back in good position.
Yeah, New England coaches and players going, what the heck are you doing? Get your little skinny rear end off the field. But, you know, the score, you look at the game, and everybody's going to just say, well, it's got to be the weather. No, it's two good defenses that are really just making life difficult for the other offenses.
Stover heads back to the sidelines after wandering around a bit and getting a good look at the latest conditions. Second and 16, and they run the draw with Falk back to the original line of scrimmage at the 20.
You know, Jim, it's true. This game, you just had to know coming in, it was not going to be pretty if you were an offensive player.
Third and 10 coming up for the Patriots. The Ravens have two timeouts remaining, and their defense needs to come up with a play. Third and 10 for New England. This Patriot team is well accustomed to playing weather games.
Well, it seems like every time I've been up here, wind, rain, snow. Even Tom Brady said something to us that he goes, gosh, do we ever just get a really good weather game? But they've adapted. They handle it very well.
Third and 10. Good time for Brady. Going long and over the head of Patton, who looked around for a hold call on McAllister and doesn't get it. And now Brady's coming over to make an appeal. So Josh Miller has struggled. He has shanked two punts, and this one will be booted near the 10-yard line.
It's into the wind, too. There's quite a bit of wind on the field. Bonnie Bernstein said so, or told us so. Into the wind, you got to play it short.
And another one that's not traveling real far. Sam's at the 43 and runs into Bruschi and Dexter Reed at the 48. They throw on third down, thus allowing Baltimore to conserve on the timeouts. They have two to go. From the 48 of the Patriots. And movement by the substitute starter, Ethan Brooks.
Right of the snap, false start, offense, number 77. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
So they'll go from the 48 of New England and go back into their own end at the 47. First and 15. Six possessions, five punts, and a pick.
Troy Brown, he's at corner now, covering a wide receiver. Well, Don Davis, the linebacker, was at safety. He is. He's just in close to the line of scrimmage.
Bowler, look down the middle, and now with no chance, Roosevelt Colvin. And a timeout called by the Patriots. Teddy Bruschi called for the timeout. Second and 27 coming up when we return. Roosevelt Colvin with his fourth sack of the season, and suddenly things have turned. Now the Patriots use a timeout. Each team has two in the pocket with 1:26 to go in the half.
Roosevelt Colvin, when he was brought in here last year as a free agent from the Chicago Bears, I said, this will be the difference in this Patriots defense. Outside pass rusher, more speed, gets hurt. They did pretty well without him, but he's rounding back into football shape.
So Bowler's back under center. And that pass, not his best, looking for Travis Taylor.
Yeah, he's lost the rhythm. Travis Taylor wide open that time, but Kyle Bowler a little quick with the football. Just not relaxing. We talked about it earlier, how he's relaxing and just letting it go down the field. Look at Travis Taylor. Nobody around him.
He'd gotten away from Troy Brown, who was defending.
Well, what happens to a quarterback when you get hit about three plays in a row, you just take for granted on the fourth when you're going to get hit again. And all of a sudden you get good protection, but you rush the throw.
Third down and 27. Bullard down the field and almost picked for the second time by Randall Gay.
Well, that's a lack of patience by Kyle Bowler. You play for the Baltimore Ravens. You're the quarterback of the football team. You know you got a good defense. You're losing 3-0. Randall Gay, you saw it earlier. Exactly the same defense. He leaves his guy, falls off on the inside receiver, and probably should have had the interception.
Travis Taylor helped make a play to ensure no pick. So Bowler's hit only one of his last seven. And Nick Murphy back on the field. This one end over end, and Falk fields it. No, it gets over his head. Back at the 16, he pays for it. Roderick Green levels him back at the 15-yard line.
Bill Belichick talked about the special teams for the Baltimore Ravens. He says they're bigger than most teams. They're explosive. This is a good shot of what he was talking about. A big linebacker. Listen.
Oh. He actually, when he was talking about the special teams, talking about Bill Belichick, talking about Baltimore special teams, he used a term you weren't familiar with when describing special teams. Talking about how they just said they're physical.
They're physical. Yeah, you don't hear that.
He said, I've never heard that.
Yeah, it's always fast. They got all these little guys. But the Ravens, they have some defensive linemen, a lot of linebackers who run down there. And, of course, Jim, the bigger you are, the harder you hit.
Well, they just take a kneel down. And Baltimore, with two timeouts, let some time go. And now the Ravens use a timeout with 56 seconds.
Tom Brady thought he caught 12 guys on the field. He did not.
Well, the Ravens could get the ball back with some time in the half.
It's amazing. The Ravens did it two possessions ago. New England did it to the Ravens offense. Now the Ravens are going to try to do it back to New England.
Second down and 11 from Corey Dillon. Patriots did not want him to go out of bounds.
Baltimore still with one timeout, 51 seconds ago. It kind of forces New England now, if they weren't going to throw the football, the chances of throwing it have gone up dramatically. Look at Bill Belichick. I know he's thinking about it. Prides is himself and the football team being smart mentally. Corey Dillon not paying attention to what was going on here at the end of the first half.
Third and 9 from the muddiest portion of the field, and Dillon gets only a yard. So 46 seconds, and the Ravens use their last timeout. But that means that Josh Miller returns to the field. He's struggled in this first half. We'll be right back. Fourth and 7, that whole series very unpatriot-like.
There should be about 12 to 15 seconds left to go in the first half. But, Jim, we talked about it since Corey Dillon ran out of bounds. Baltimore, 46 seconds left. Miller punting into the wind.
It has been dusty today, but it's quiet at the moment. Sams has a chance to get Baltimore good field position. And maybe a face mask. Yes, here comes the flag as Matt Chatham was in on the hit.
That puts him in field goal range right now.
And there's two more thrown in for good measure after the face mask call. I think we're going to have two separate penalties here. The face mask and something in the aftermath. Unsportsmanlike conduct penalty. And this is going against the Patriots.
Face mask, personal foul.
Oh, boy.
Oh.
Matt Chatham.
That is so frightening when you see it. Had him strong enough to jerk his entire body around and swing him down.
Plus, the neck. Jim, you have a dead ball, unsportsmanlike conduct. I could not tell who it was against. I was trying to read.
Well, it's 30 yards of penalties in all.
It was against Teddy Bruschi.
So it's 15 plus 15 down to the 16. What a turnaround in the last minute of the first half.
No timeouts for the Baltimore Ravens.
Starting to rain rather heavily now. Ravens first snap inside the 20. And it's over to Taylor. Bobbles it for a moment and tries to get out. And they say he does. With 30 seconds and very little gain. Maybe Matt Stover knew what he was doing all along out there, imagining a kick. He was just maybe one series too early.
Yeah, that's right. He was quite a bit early, but.
Second down, 11, with 30 seconds to go in the half. Two big penalties on the Patriots have set up the Ravens to do something. Going to the locker room, and Bowler swings it over. Wilcox needs to get out of bounds. For a moment, he thought about cutting back to the inside, then gets out to stop the clock with 23 seconds. Vrabel and Don Davis.
Yeah, now this is Jim. This is patience by a quarterback. Not looking down the field. You don't have to get 7 points. What a move by Wilcox. Fakes the defender out and allows him to get out of bounds, and it gives the Baltimore Ravens one more chance to throw the football into the end zone.
With 23 seconds to go in the first half, the Ravens have been shut out to this point. First and goal and rolling right. Look out, this is Clarence Moore. They better hurry back to the line. The rookie, that really had almost no benefit for the Ravens. Gain of three, but using up all this time.
Spike it.
Nine really. Seconds.
Excellent job, though, Jim. I think they did it all the right way. Excellent job. Pick up the first down, spike the football, and they got 9 seconds left. That is as good as you could hope to do in a situation like that. Now you can run one play. We saw this quite similar to the Jets.
Yes, I was going to say, the last time we saw the Ravens 2 weeks ago, almost an identical situation at the end of regulation. There were 8 seconds for the Jets. Same basic point on the field, no timeouts. And, of course, they kicked the field goal to send it to overtime.
Difference here, Kyle Bowler, more experience. They trust him. It's a good decision. I like what they're trying here.
With 9 seconds to go in the half, Bowler lobs it in zone, and Randy Himes can't hold on. It took only 4 seconds. They'll bring out Stover this time.
Boy, that was close. Good job by Kyle Bowler. Don't hold it. You know the situation. The wind, the football actually looked like it curved about 2 feet as it was up in the air. But a good job by the Ravens and Kyle Bowler there at the end of the half, giving themselves a chance to score a touchdown.
Stover, like Vinatieri, has missed only once this year. He's got a somewhat dry patch, not a muddy area, from 22 yards. And Stover ties the game at 3. 3-3. Ravens get a late gift with a pair of personal fouls, and it results in a field goal.
Look at that, Jonathan Ogden. He likes this. Look at him, all the mud, and you know, only a lineman could like this stuff.
He's just glad to be back playing after missing a couple of games. He returned last week in the game against the Cowboys. 7-time Pro Bowler. So just 2 seconds to go in the half. Over with the driving kick, fielded in one hop by Patrick Pass. And Pass finds the run arrested at the 32-yard line. Well, we're only 100 points behind the Cincinnati and Cleveland game. Maybe we'll have that explosive second half. Let's go down to Bonnie Bernstein.
Jim, New England's averaged 32 points the last three games. Brian Billick, has your defense kept them in check?
Well, they're playing a good sound game. We gave up a couple big plays that let them out of a hole. Outside of that, they played very well. We got to find some way to generate more offense.
Coach, thanks.
We had 12 punts in the half and only 6 points. 3-3 at halftime in Foxborough. We'll be back with the Nextel Halftime Report after this message and a word from your local station. Vinatieri good from 28. Stover from 22. Defense rules in this weather game. And you're watching the NFL on CBS. Billick's team trying to find one on the road. A game that's been dominated by defense. A battle in the trenches that will continue when the third quarter begins in a moment. You're watching the NFL on CBS. Ravens and Patriots, is it the first matchup of the season? Talking to Brian Billick, he said we need to go up there and stake our ground because I think we may see them again up there in Foxborough. And they did stake the ground in that first half.
Kind of like an animal, right? You want to stake their territory.
That's
we
right.
can do it
Mark
here.
It off.
You know, I look at this game, the weather, the defenses, they're both outstanding, the defenses. First 1-10 is going to win.
It might be.
It's going to be tough to score up here.
All right, well, the first half numbers, they aren't pretty. We had 12 punts in that first half. Total yards 95 by the Ravens, and we've measured
the mud
depth
just 3 inches.
Not bad.
Need some long cleats and
maybe
whatever,
more than that.
There are parts of this field though, you could the rain and it's starting to come down again. It is getting sloppy in the middle.
Hope somebody picked up the ruler. Kick down to Bethel Johnson. And Bethel Johnson with some swift running. And he gets all the way past the 40-yard line. Ball squirts loose at the end. They're going to rule him down. Fantasy numbers, not what you're looking for unless you own one of these defenses. Bowler threw for 64 yards, was picked by Randall Gay. Taylor had 32 yards rushing, also 4 receptions for 20 yards. Or give him 3 receptions. Actually, that's Travis Taylor with the 3 catches. Wilcox with a pair, Branch with 3, and Givens 3 short ones. That's it.
Well, in a game with this weather, with the defenses, you're looking for any edge. So that nice return can change field position. It's not about scoring points all the time. It's about changing field position.
Anthony Weaver and Ray Lewis quickly on top of Corey Dillon.
Holding defense number 97. 5-yard penalty on the end of the run. First down.
So a good start here for the Patriots with the run back and now the penalty. And let's go back down to Bonnie Bernstein.
Jim, you'll remember Bill Belichick couldn't stress enough before the game how important it was for his team to be physical. He told me coming out of halftime, his team is not matching Baltimore's intensity. He said there's a lot of things that aren't going right for us. He pointed out the 2 penalties on the punt return for Baltimore that put him in scoring position. He said this we thought was going to be our true test against Baltimore's defense, and it sure is.
Great time for Brady, and that could have been picked. Gary Baxter got hit in the back, and Ray Lewis was down the field also as they doubled up on David Givens.
Yeah, Ray Lewis actually gets in the way of the interception. He saves Tom Brady, running down the middle of the field with the receiver, with Givens. Baxter can't get out of the way of Ray Lewis to get the ball.
Ray Lewis without an interception this season. He had six last year. Was tops for all linebackers in the NFL. None this year so far. Second down. Look at the play by Gibbons. And tiptoes ahead to the 36 for a 14-yard gain.
I was going to say, Jim, it's harder for Ray Lewis to get some of the action that he's used to because Ed Reed and some of the other players have just made more plays. But this is what you do against a good defense. Throw it short. Just hope some of your guys can take quick throws or runs and get some extra yards. And Chris McAllister misses the tackle that time.
Yeah, he stepped right aside, McAllister. Raining hard on first down, and Dillon stood up by Ray Lewis. Gain of four.
Corey Dillon, we talked about how he brings power to this New England offense, to the running game. He is a big man, and he gets a lot of his extra yards because he's got those big arms and just sticks it out there. Boy, he's running fast. He's strong, and he puts a right arm out at you. That'd knock a lot of guys down.
Patriots, second down and six. And Gibbons, wow. How did he hold on? Ray Lewis hammers him after the hit, but a 10-yard completion.
Well, we talk about so many things in a game like this. You know it's not going to be pretty. And if you're on offense, hey, mark it down. You're going to take some big hits.
A big rain squall hovering over Gillette Stadium as the Patriots are driving to begin the second half. Up the middle, Dillon. And back pedals down to the 17.
Boy, nice drive by the Patriots. It all started out with the hard running by Bethel Johnson on the kickoff. Picked up about 15 or 20 extra yards and just gave the Patriots offense some life, and they've taken advantage of it.
It's hard to throw on this Ravens defense. The opponent quarterback pass rating is lowest in the league. And Brady, though, is finding a little bit of a rhythm and a nice pass and catch combo with David Gibbons to start the half. Second down and three. And Ed Reed comes up to make the play.
Ed Reed's playing like a young Rodney Harrison. He's just everywhere. He's back. He came up. Tom Brady's trying to change the play. And I believe that on the outside, Ed Reed snuck up, comes in, and you talked about it. He just does not miss tackles. I think Tom Brady thought that he came up so quick that he was getting bluffed, so he didn't change the play from an outside run. But when you mix it up, it's hard to read the mind of good players.
Reed eliminates 5 yards off the Dillon total and sets the Patriots back to third and eight from the 22-yard line.
Here they come.
They pick up the blitz. Brady, right side, Patton, and incomplete. Walloped by Gary Baxter to knock the ball loose.
That's about the proper word, Jim. Just walloped. He just sees the football, he reacts to it, and the force of his reaction just knocks the football away from David Patton for the first down.
Not to put the announcer hex on it, but Adam Vinatieri has the longest active streak in the league going right now. He's made his last 19, took over after Phil Dawson missed last week for Cleveland. This from 40 yards. And Vinatieri is good again. Two for two on the day, Vinatieri. 6-3, all field goals to this point, Patriots lead. Adam Vinatieri in his ninth year has had 17 game-winning kicks in his career, including two Super Bowls. Phil, are we talking about a Hall of Fame player right here?
Jim, if you ask me, if I had a vote, absolutely. Two game-winning kicks and field goals field goal winning kicks, I should say. He's done in the playoffs. He does it constantly. He's a machine when you watch him kick.
Sam's swarmed under with a flag at the 18, Larry Izzo. Again, leading this team in special teams tackles for the sixth year.
Mel White's going to get a block from behind. Really just a bad play.
Well, you talked about Vinatieri, just to finish that thought, with his two winning kicks in Super Bowls, four of Belichick's.
During the return, illegal block in the back, number 30, 10-yard penalty, still first down.
Four of Belichick's six playoff wins at New England have been won by Vinatieri in the end.
Really, you know, we wouldn't be talking about all those streaks and everything else. Remember the snow kicks that he made against the Oakland Raiders before the Patriots won their first Super Bowl. So he continued and gave him a chance to go on and have such great success.
Tough position for the Ravens, now trailing 6-3. Penalty brings him back to the 9, and Taylor can only pick up two. Ted Johnson. All those winning kicks for Vinatieri. 17 game winners overall. Four in the playoffs. Two in the Super Bowl. The Jackrabbit from South Dakota State. South Dakota State Jackrabbits, who put his own videotapes together and distribute them around the NFL, hoping someone would take note. Brad Sheely did. What a career it's been. Phil, you say Hall of Fame career.
Yeah, I believe so.
Second down and 9. And Taylor continues to give it a lot of second effort here. But it'll be third and short coming up. Rodney Harrison brings him about 2 yards shy of the first. Next Saturday, Auburn and Tennessee in the SEC Championship game presented by Dr. Pepper. Auburn and Tennessee from Atlanta, Georgia. That's coming your way next weekend, 6 o'clock Eastern time, right here on CBS. Third, and we'll call it 3. More like about a yard to go. And what a play. Teddy Bruschi lowers the shoulder on Chester Taylor, and it's a 5-yard loss.
Teddy Bruschi, Bill Belichick just says, this guy is a football player. And what he means by that, no matter what situation you put him in, you know he's going to do the right thing. Just has a feel for where the football is going to go. What a hit.
And
that
man,
time by Teddy Bruschi.
Is it getting ugly outside? Troy Brown is back to return the kick of Nick Murphy. Troy Brown playing a little offense. Whole lot of defense and returning punts. Beautiful boot, a spiral. Fielded by Brown at the 40. And finally brought down at the 48. 48-yard punt. Teddy Bruschi so often knows where to be in the right place. He's done it again. In the mud, New England leading 6-3 and starting this drive at its own 48. Had a shot at him first, then Fuller. And Dillon runs out of bounds after a gain of about 10. Jed Weaver was on that side helping open up the edge.
Well, it's a good job by the New England Patriots. They have a tight end on each side. So what it really does, when you put a tight end on each side of your formation, it allows Corey Dillon just to take the football and decide where he's going to run. And he picked the proper spot. Going left. Again, we showed you earlier that stiff arm he can use, and he picked up a first down.
I liked what Bill Belichick said about Corey Dillon when we talked with him this week. He's just so impressed with what Dillon has brought to this team after being picked up in a trade with Cincinnati in the spring for a second-round pick with the Bengals. He said, you know, he's not a major personality. He's not flashy. He's not loud. I'm not saying he's low-key. He's just a real solid guy, and I think he's learned more about him in some moments of adversity this season. Not that there have been that many, but when he fumbled a couple of times, he learned more about Dillon than anything else.
Yeah, you see the players that acquired last offseason, what they've done this year. Corey Dillon has been the most productive, but you're right, Jim. He learned because he fumbled, and he learned it. He just goes, wow, it really hurt this guy deep, and he couldn't get over it, and it reminded me of somebody for Bill Belichick.
It reminded him of Roger Staubach when Bill was a young boy and hanging around with his father, Steve, who was an assistant at the Naval Academy. And Roger was winning the Heisman Trophy. And here's Dillon again. Great blocking, including Givens opening up the side. And look at Dillon stay on his feet.
Yeah, he looked like Roger to Dodger that time.
He did.
But again, the Patriots have found a little something up front. They're getting those tight ends, and they just crush it down inside. David Givens, nice block on the outside against Baxter. And then Corey Dillon, strong, elusive, picks up the extra yards. Well, that is some good blocking by the Patriots, but yeah. Belichick, just to finish your story, Jim, he says Roger Staubach could never let it go either. When he lost a game and made bad plays, it just stayed with him. And that's just a mark of a person who cares deeply about what he's doing.
It's Patrick Pass giving Dillon a rest, picking up about 2 yards. It would take Roger Staubach, he remembered sometimes till Wednesday or Thursday, to let it go.
Yeah.
He just couldn't let go of the game. And when Dillon fumbled in a couple of situations, including at Kansas City on Monday night, he said it really bothered him. Just, yeah. You know, just really, not that it doesn't bother everyone, but just like the fierceness with which he competes, made an impression on his coach.
Well, this Patriots team has gotten tough. Bonnie Bernstein said Bill Belichick wasn't happy about how physical they were in the first half. They are winning the battle here in the second.
Patton in the end zone. A flag is thrown. This could be against Patton for pushing off.
His arms did come out in front of him.
Raymond Walls was back covering, and Patton shoved him a little bit.
Interference. Offense.
Yep.
Number 86. 10-yard penalty.
I'm not sure if the David Patton, by moving his arms, had anything to do with the play. The bottom of your screen, watch Patton going down the field. His arms, oh, there it was. And that was a really good call. Just that little push, and look what happens. It makes the defensive back just stop completely.
Crowd doesn't like it, but it's the right call.
It is.
This whole point of emphasis is you see Brady. He thinks he's got a touchdown, and then wait a minute.
Well, like all quarterbacks, he wants to hear the penalty. But think about it this way, and I always say this, Jim. If you're running down somewhere and going full speed, and if somebody just sticks their arm out and hits you just a little bit, think what that's going to do. That will knock you off balance and slow you down, and that's what happened on that last play.
Second and 18, and another flag thrown in the backfield. And Patrick Pass collects the pass. But this is another one against the Patriots. My goodness. A moment ago, they thought they had six more on the board, and now back-to-back penalties.
They might have had the game won.
Personal foul. Grabbing the face mask. Number 63 offense. 15-yard penalty. Still second down.
Called on Joe Andruzzi. That whole point of emphasis this year that we've seen past 5 yards beyond the line of scrimmage. It works both ways.
Yeah, it does. And you know what? I've seen more offensive pass interference calls this year than I have in years past, and rightly so. You know, too, I'm kind of glad because I get tired of hearing all the defensive players saying, oh, everything is done for the offense. Here it comes. Joe Andruzzi, 63, hand on the face mask of Adalys Thomas. It was a quick one, but the hand, or it did grab the face mask just for a second.
It's the second face mask call against the Patriots. The one at the end of the first half helped set up a field goal by Stover. 4 personal fouls on New England in all today. And now it's second and 33. And they're bringing everybody. The middle open for a moment, but they close in on Patrick Pass. Thomas and Chad Williams.
You know, we keep talking about, and we've done it a couple times, Brian Billick trying to say his team needs to stake its ground here in New England in case they come up here and have to play later in the year. But and we haven't talked about enough on the other side that, you know, New England's trying to show them and show everybody that, hey, we've won 2 Super Bowls the last 3 years, and we're not ready to give it up. So that's what disappointed Bill Belichick in the first half. You know, fight back. When you get hit, hit them back.
Try to keep pace in the AFC with the Pittsburgh Steelers, who won earlier today and are now 10-1. Safety foul. Patrick Pass. Can he get far enough for field goal range? Down to the 30.
Interesting. 47-yarder from here. What will they do?
They're going to bring out Vinatieri.
Here comes the machine.
Tom Brady trying to look down the field. The Baltimore Ravens, they know it. Double covering David Patton to the outside. Good job by Tom Brady showing some patience.
This will be a tough one for Vinatieri with the messy conditions. But again, he has kicked in snow and rain and sleet and everything else.
He's so good he can overcome the Jim Nance hex.
He has made 20 consecutive field goals, longest streak in the league. Kicked by Vinatieri. It's good again. 48 yards for Adam Vinatieri, 9-3 New England. Well, they're celebrating another field goal here in Foxborough. Adam Vinatieri, 3-for-3 on the day. And 28 of 29 on the season.
Shoot, if it was Thanksgiving Day, I'd give him the All-Iron Award.
I thought you told me you'd never give it to a kicker.
No, he's different. He's not like a kicker. He's so competitive and so tough.
Fumbled around for a moment, finally scooped up by Sams. And Patrick Pass playing special teams. Makes the hit at the 23. Vinatieri from 48 muddy yards. Puts New England up by 6. From the 23, Chester Taylor met at the line. Rodney Harrison finishes him off after a gain of 2. McGinnis had him for a moment, wrapped up for a loss. He shook that off, picks up a couple.
Well, Kyle Bowler's got his gloves back on, so I think it's just gotten so bad he knows he needs them. But, you know, you're in a part of the game, and they've been here before, the Baltimore Ravens. It's been a rough day so far for Kyle Bowler, but you've got to remain patient. You still have to go on the premise that one play, you can be back in this game. And remember, your defense is not playing great, but always can get you back in the game, too.
Dangerous throw, almost picked up by McGinnis.
I tell you what, too, when you watch the quarterback, I talked about this early with Kyle Bowler. When he looks to his right, the ball does get tipped at the line of scrimmage. As he stands there and looks, Vince Wilfork has the tip. The defenders underneath, that is the key. The underneath defenders move and get in the way of the ball thrown down the field.
I'll tell you, that's two tip plays today by the rookie Vince Wilfork. And 8 to Travis Taylor, and Earthwind Moreland was defending. He was overthrown.
What a job by this New England secondary. Don Davis, linebacker at safety, Troy Brown playing one of the wide receivers. And I know Baltimore thought they were going to get some big pass plays and they were going to get wide open. That has not been the case.
So Troy Brown is back to field the punt after Kevin Faulk had one bounce over his head. And then late in the second quarter, he has not returned as the returner.
Went in down. Put Troy Brown back there. He'll take care of it for you.
And then that really holds true for any position. Brown across the 30 and out of bounds at the 38. And here comes another flag across the field.
And that was a great toss.
I'm telling you, it was thrown some 30 yards in the air.
But you talk about Troy Brown. Came in the league, special teams a little bit, third down back, maybe fourth or fifth wide receiver.
After the play, late hit, out of bounds.
Ooh.
Number 57, defense, 15-yard penalty, first down.
Bart Scott with the late hit, and that'll put the Patriots into Baltimore territory near the 48. 2-3 and outs for the Ravens in this half. 2 field goals by the Pats.
Bart Scott, number 57, gets called for the late hit. Troy Brown still had 1 foot in the field of play, so that was a tough 15 yards that the Baltimore Ravens are giving up in a game that's close, it's physical. Hate to complain, you just got to let them play.
Matt Chatham, you could see him trying to encourage the official to throw the flag. He won the case. 4-yard gain for Corey Dillon.
I'll tell you the other thing. Look at the starting drives for both teams. New England or Baltimore, 41 now on their own 17. And look at New England. Field position has changed, but more than that, attitude and the way the game is being played. the New England Patriots, we've said they've turned into a power running team with Corey Dillon. This offensive line has gotten better, and they are winning up front.
Second down and six, the delay give, and Dillon straight ahead, about a half yard shy of the first, and we have an update. We hand it off now to Greg Gumbel down in New York.
All right, Jim, out in Arizona. Quincy Carter had his bell rung earlier. How's this for a way to get back into the game? 69 yards to Santana Moss, 13-3. The Jets in the lead. Fourth quarter just underway in Arizona, guys.
All right, thank you, Greg. Pretty impressive comeback for Quincy Carter as the Jets start two games behind the Patriots in the AFC East.
Did he, as they would say in golf, did he get all of it? Because Quincy launched it.
He did.
And then, you know,
Bollinger had to come in and play the whole second quarter for Carter in that game.
I think that's one thing they like about Quincy Carter. He can move around, but that's becoming less a factor in the National Football League, and everybody's got to realize it. But he can throw it as far as about anybody right now in the league.
So about a half yard shy of the first, and here's your NFL.com poll. Will Peyton Manning break Marino's single season record of 48 touchdown passes? He's at 41 right now.
And what'd you say?
Cast your vote at NFL.com. I say if you say no, we're going to take your computer away.
And look at Peyton Manning, an All-Iron Award winner.
Yeah.
Him and his offensive line, though, the offensive line, you know, come on. Let's start talking about them more. But what numbers Peyton Manning put up.
He earned the All-Iron, Bill Simms All-Iron Award, and got the BlackBerry compliment.
Yeah. I heard it burned his tongue a little, man. It was a little high.
Seymour in the backfield on third and one. This time he makes some contact and helps clear the way for the first down with Dillon.
I'll tell you what, this is 9-3, and there are a lot of good things going on for this New England offense right now, and most of it's number 28. If you talk about just being tough, the rain, the weather, he is just, he's looking for some punishment. Yeah, take that. Always wanted to do a few sound effects. That was good.
Do that some more.
It is just, it really, the weather, it's just tough running by Corey Dillon, and he has been the biggest difference so far.
And Seymour stays in the game as Brady just gets the snap away in time.
Oh, what blocking by Seymour up front.
Taken to the line, and Divins got tangled with Gary Baxter, and no flag.
Well, Tom Brady's allowed to throw this down the field. Richard Seymour, look at big Richard Seymour outside, but watch him down the field. Baxter, he has his ground. That is just good coverage by Baxter. Watch Richard Seymour at fullback.
Yeah, he got Suggs.
Yeah, Suggs. This is not no little running back anymore. This is a big man.
He can handle it.
I tell you, I love it. I love it. And Jim, we will remember this. Next year, we're going to see more of this by other teams. They're going to copy what the Patriots are doing.
Second down and 10, and Brady dancing around and looking for Daniel Graham, and no flag. And now Quad comes in late.
That's a bad call. Well, I hate to always second-guess officials. He was in perfect position, and he turned and looked for the football.
Dallas Thomas.
Of course, if I see a replay, I can change my mind.
Interference, 96 defense, not playing the ball. First down.
That's where they were tangled up. Look at this.
Look at that field. Let's watch Adalis Thomas to the left. Linebacker. Tom Brady goes out.
All right.
He didn't turn as quick as I thought he did. But he's looking for the ball, trying to make a play, and he is allowed to stay in the position that he's in. The receiver turns and tries to go through him.
So a new set of downs for New England from the 24. Quickly over to Givens. And Corey Fuller shuts it down. Fuller shuts it down after a three-yard gain. Let's go back to Greg.
All right, guys, in Seattle, the Buffalo Bills looking for their first road win of the season, doing quite nicely. Willis McGahee, his second two-yard touchdown run of the day. The Bills lead the Seahawks 24-3 early in the fourth.
Wow, thank you, Greg. That's an impressive performance by the Bills. And you think of a couple of stinging losses they had this season. They have really rallied what was a terrible start.
Yes, it's...
Could be 5-6 at the end of the day if they hold on there, which they should. Corey Dillon met the line, and he'll lose yards. Maybe just one, but it's Ray Lewis and Ed Hartwell combining.
Ray Lewis, haven't heard that name much today.
Do you know how big one more field goal would be in this game with these conditions?
It's like being up three scores. Ray Lewis, number 52. Watching Corey Dillon. That time he's protected, not blocked, and he's allowed to get in there and get part of the tackle.
So Gibbons to the left. The veteran Corey Fuller will defend him. They've got Branch and Patton to the right on 3rd and 6. Brady goes over to Branch. Gets the first down. He's at the 10 and down at the 5. Got away from Gary Baxter. Eventually recovered and brought him down along with Will Demps. 15 yards for Branch.
Deion Branch looks so quick against, just takes his time, goes out slow, kind of lulls Baxter to sleep. Nice move down the field, I tell you, too. Tom Brady, look at that throw. Conditions are getting tough, and he's able just to get enough on the football to get it to Deion Branch.
They'll bring back Richard Seymour into the backfield, and Mike Vrabel, the linebacker, on the line on the left-hand side. Running right with Dillon. Dillon to the 1. And he is double hit there by Demps and Lewis.
Well, I'd say right now the New England Patriots are staking their ground. That's what they're doing. They are taking it to the Baltimore Ravens.
They're going to close out the quarter and another one of their streaks. They have won 35 straight when leading after three quarters. They lead and they're looking to go in for more. We head to the final quarter and it has been steady rain throughout. But the key here, the Patriots a couple yards away from going in. Game of all field goals to this point. Second and goal, and Dillon opens the quarter with a touchdown. Running behind Richard Seymour.
Right into Ray Lewis, and he just continued on for the touchdown. Boy, what a game by Corey Dillon. And if there's ever any doubt about this Patriots football team, what are they now? Shoot, they line up and hit you in the mouth. That's what they do.
Look at
Richard Seymour.
He got a couple of players.
He finally found somebody.
Well, he got Suggs a moment ago,
yeah,
too.
That's true. That's right.
And the other 3rd and 1 on this drive, he also made a nice hit.
But he was looking for some serious contact.
Well, look at this. They're going to go for 2.
Right, 15-3. They want to get up 2 touchdowns. They're up 12, so this is a good call by Bill Belichick.
Gibbons in motion. Back to Dillon, and wow, what an effort. Straight ahead to get it for 2.
That was the call. Not enough defenders in there to stop the run. Tom Brady alertly calls the run.
Ran behind Neal. Corey Dillon, a touchdown and a 2. And the Patriots take a big lead here. 17-3. Now Corey Dillon doing so much of the heavy work. In the mess today at Foxborough. 17-3. Kick away to Sams at the 8. And he gets it out to the 30.
Total domination up front by the Patriots. That's what this last touchdown's about. Daniel Graham, Christian Fourier, good blocks. Richard Seymour, watch them all. Boy, Daniel Graham just powders his guy to the ground. Richard Seymour gets a lot of contact. Look at Fourier's block outside. And then Corey Dillon just runs over Ray Lewis. 2-point conversion, not enough defenders inside. They have no chance of stopping the run by Corey Dillon.
Bowler getting chased and getting dropped back at the 19-yard line by Ted Johnson.
How about that? Ted Johnson
has come a long way back from a couple years ago when he was unhappy about the way his position was on this football team. As Bill Belichick told us the other day, that he is probably the best conditioned player on the Patriots.
Second sack by New England, and it's good for a 10-yard loss. Second down and 20. Bowler, two straight times and a ball loose. Taylor in the area to fall on it. Now it's free. Recovered by Green for a touchdown. Jarvis Green and the Patriots are on the board again. Teddy Bruschi knocked the ball loose.
Overpowering, that's what it is. This has got to be the most impressive victory of the year for the New England Patriots. The offense is overpowered, the Baltimore defense, and now the defense, they are just having their way with Kyle Bowler and the rest of the Ravens offensive line.
Jarvis Green with his first career touchdown.
I can hear the water.
15 points in 42 seconds.
Well, your secondary's all beat up, but Kyle Bowler can't find anywhere to throw it. Mike Vrabel on the blitz. Teddy Bruschi causes a fumble, and it's just a race to see who can get it. Jarvis Green. Boy, that's a nice recovery by Jarvis Green. Teddy Bruschi coming from the left of the offense. Mike Vrabel was called. Oh, what a move by Teddy Bruschi. He went around two people.
Bill Belichick was talking this week about Troy Brown just being an instinctive football player and how he has so many multiple uses. But he said, you know, he's a lot like Teddy Bruschi, like that. Just a football player who knows how to be, again, at the right place all the time.
I tell you what, it was, as soon as he said it, I go, well, that's a heck of a compliment to say. Because Teddy Bruschi is, what you say, he's not big enough, he's not fast enough, but he's everywhere.
How many times have you seen games like this, though, in late season in Foxborough? I take, for example, the game up here late last year in the snow where Bruschi made the pick late, scored a touchdown against Miami.
Won the game. The Patriots have taught themselves, they play so many different guys in so many roles. They're so mentally tough, and of course they're physically tough, that can you just take it? They just grind on you for so long that when you crack, look out, man, because then they take advantage of it.
Have the Patriots owned this half? They have held the Ravens, not held, they have, like, taken back the Ravens, minus 22 yards in the half.
That's unbelievable.
How about that? And another big hit. Kropelkis with the hit. And that was impressive as well.
Shoot, you're Kyle Bowler right now. I know what I would be thinking. Survival. It's tough. Just try to do anything to get a first down. Settle the defense down. Settle the crowd down. And give your team a little bit of confidence.
Justin Kropelkis.
Oh, look at that football. How'd I throw that for a living?
Wow. And try to throw it with your deficit now, three touchdowns.
Good call. Run it.
Kropelkis sets it back at the 25, and it's a five-yard run by Taylor. We've got another update. Let's send it back to you, Greg, in New York.
All right, Jim. Sneaky, crafty quarterback veteran Drew Bledsoe. Watch him. A little tomfoolery over here, and then toss it to Willis McGahee over there. McGahee goes 30 yards for a touchdown. Buffalo is coasting at Seattle. It's now 31-3, 10.5 to play in the fourth quarter, guys.
All right, Greg, and I would say Seattle's one of the most enigmatic teams in the league this year. How do you figure this team?
They got exposed a few weeks ago. I'll tell you what, that was a nice little play by Drew Bledsoe.
And Taylor fights ahead for a first down.
I'll tell you the problem with Buffalo is they play in the same division as New England. That's one of their big problems.
Well, they don't have to see them again. They've already had their two encounters.
But
two
look
losses.
At this, Jim. Look at this up front. Oh, yeah, I love it. It's muddy. I love people. Oh, it's football weather. Whoever came up with that statement, hey,
He didn't play quarterback, I'll tell you that.
When you'd wake up and find a forecast like this, what would you think?
Oh, misery. Here it goes. Starting to break out in hives.
First and 10, and McGinnis chasing after Bowler. He can only fire it away.
Is right.
Jamel White in the backfield, his second carry of the game. And Davis makes the play on him after 5 yards, third and 5 coming up.
You know, good calls. Call some running plays in a situation like this, because the defensive players, they want to get to the quarterback. So, and they're going to give up some runs they wouldn't have given up a couple series ago, and it takes a lot of pressure off Kyle Bowler.
Troy Brown is in on defense. Teddy Bruschi ready to pounce. Third down and 5. Bullet has it knocked down by Brown. Troy Brown, one of 2 offensive captains for the Patriots. Brady is the other. Makes the defensive play.
I was just getting ready to say, I'm not kidding you, I was watching Troy Brown. I tried to watch him all day. That we saw him against the St. Louis Rams about 3 weeks ago, whenever it was, and he was just okay. But every time you watch him, he gets better and better. And he was all over Johnson that time going down the field.
Had to get a little mud out of his eyes because that ball came in there, I'm sure, a little dirty. Now he's back to field the punt. Oh, and bobbles the fair catch. And he's laughing about that one, too. 24-3, a lot of smiles now in New England. 24-3, New England. And the Patriots with 115 yards in this half. Ravens minus 6. Dillon dancing around and picking up short yardage. Ed Hartwell stood him up. This week marked the 10-year anniversary of the purchase of the Patriots.
Wow.
By Robert Kraft. Bought him Thanksgiving week from the Sullivan family in 1994. In that span, he's built this magnificent stadium and seen his franchise go from really one of the doormats of the league to 3 Super Bowls in all, with 2 Super Bowl championships.
You know what they've turned into? The model in so many different ways of what you want your franchise to be. Look at it, 10 years. They've been to 3 Super Bowl in his reign, 10 years.
And Corey Dillon picks up the first down.
And you know what's really impressive about this Patriots team? I'm just sitting here thinking, I always look for cracks. And I do. Maybe it's just the way I am. But I watch players. Well, somebody's down on the field.
Looks like Matt Light. The left tackle, and a good one.
Yeah, their offensive line has had a few injuries. They've overcome it.
So, timeout on the field with 11 minutes remaining. Been raining all day at New England. Jim Nance, Phil Sims, Bonnie Bernstein, and the CBS team. This matchup of Baltimore and the New England Patriots, with New England leading 24-3, and the Patriots left tackle Matt Light suffering an injury on that last play.
Matt Light, left tackle. Seed number 72. Oh, and he just pulls up. I thought he was hit at first, so why am I not going to speculate? I know better. But the fact that he's walking off slowly is a good sign for the New England Patriots.
Russ Hochstein has come in to replace him at left tackle. They've already lost for the season Tom Ashworth, their right tackle. Hochstein on that left side, and it's Corey Dillon, who's just moved over 100 for the game. Picks up another 3-4 yards.
You know, Jim, I wanted to go back to that thought I had right before Matt Light got hurt, is that when you look at this Patriots team, when teams win Super Bowls, always look for the little cracks that can undo what they're doing. But the Patriots, as you look at their older players, Willie McGinnis, some of the linemen, Teddy Bruschi, whoever, Rodney Harrison, they're not slowing down.
they're as good this year or maybe better than they were last year.
I tell you, Corey Dillon is wearing him down as he picks up another 13 yards. 122 on the game. Next week, the Patriots hit the road and will go to Cleveland. Regional action. Some of you will see that game. Many of you will see Denver out at San Diego. Phil, look forward to all the crew here working their third game in the last week. Producer Lance Barrow and our director Mike Arnold with our associate director Steve Karasek and Pete Radovich Jr. as Patrick Pass with a nifty move and a late flag, a pickup of 7. So Corey Dillon has yet another 100-yard performance. This will be now 5 of 6 games, and the only game in that stretch that he missed was on Monday night when he had 98 against Kansas City.
Personal foul, face mask, number 20, defense, 15-yard penalty, first down.
Ed Reed called for this face mask.
Well, I'll tell you what, this Baltimore defense is going to have to decide what they're going to do because the Patriots, they're not going to slow down. They're going to keep pounding it at you. But do you understand what I'm saying, or do you agree? Because when I watch teams, I always look for guys to slow down. I thought maybe Troy Brown, finally he would start to slow down. Maybe, you know, Rodney Harrison would. Maybe Corey Dillon still didn't have what I thought he had in Cincinnati. But all of them, none of them are showing any signs of wearing down, slowing down, or whatever. They're still productive.
Patrick Pass for only a yard. I do agree. Let's go down to Bonnie.
Jim, for as much as the running game's not slowing down for the Patriots, you also have to look at how well Tom Brady's been able to distribute the ball this year. With Patrick Pass's 2 catches in the third quarter, he now has 8 guys who have had at least 10 receptions this year, and he's lucky that he's got unselfish teammates. He said David Givens isn't going to care if he's not getting in many balls now that Deion Branch is back. Corey doesn't care if there's a day he doesn't get a lot of carries. I don't care if I have to hand it off all the time. And you have to think, Jim, that mentality comes from Bill Belichick. He will not allow any superstar mentality.
Definition of a team, everybody's known that for years, as that slips through the hands of Deion Branch.
Yeah, definition of a team. Got to give Bonnie some kudos today. I mean, Thursday in Detroit, nice and pretty indoors. And today, you know, Bonnie, we're sorry that you're down there in the rain and it's beating off your head. Jim says he's just glad it's you down there, not him.
Right. You know you're jealous. I got Jimmy Kimmins, our camera guy, wiping me off. And, you know, this is football weather, guys. This is what we live for.
There you
for.
Go. Yeah, there you
thank
go.
You, Jimmy. That's great.
This is football weather. No, it's not. I want to come back as my next life as a football player. I want to play in a dome.
You know, it's a quarterback. It's everybody else says so, but you quarterbacks. Third down and 9, and Dillon for about 2. You know, one last thought about how these guys haven't worn down. This is a veteran team. It's also a team that has more college graduates than any other team in the NFL. It's a very smart team that loves the fact that every week they are challenged with an interesting game plan. There is no monotony here. Yeah. You hear around this organization how they can't wait until the game plan is revealed to them early in the week. It changes every week. It's not the same old thing like it is at so many places.
Yeah, you're right. That's an interesting stat. I didn't know that, but it just kind of goes in with everything, the profile, what they want in their players. But yeah, you're right, Jim. They challenge them so much mentally, and players do love that. And they respond by following through with all the stuff they give them.
All right, before Lonnie Paxton can snap it back.
I used to love 5
yard penalty. The penalty is going to be declined. Fourth down.
I used to love on Wednesdays, you get the game plan as a player and as a quarterback, I'd get it. And if I looked at it and there wasn't a lot of changes, I'd go, oh gosh, we're going to run the same stuff again this week that we did last week. But, you know, a lot of times it works.
That's not the case around here.
No, not here.
Every week you can't wait to find out how you're going to approach the game.
Well, Troy Brown, I can't wait to find out where he's going to play.
This field is getting to be just a mud bath. And it has been throughout, but especially now. And look at this, coverage and all. Well done this time by Josh Miller. Just bunted it down to the 3-yard line. A messy day in Foxborough, but one that has brought great delight to the legion of Patriot fans. Halfway through the fourth quarter with flags everywhere. And Chester Taylor for about 2 yards. You know, we're going to have at the end of the day now three teams with 10-1 records. As the Steelers have already won, Philadelphia 10-1 and clinching the NFC East. Can you imagine clinching a division at this point with five more games to play in the regular season?
No, I can't.
Illegal formation, offense, not enough men on the line of scrimmage. Penalty is declined, second down.
What do you see in your Sim spotlight?
Well, let's give a little tribute to this defense. Rodney Harrison hit the receiver, get the sack on the quarterback, or the big hit. Roosevelt Colvin, how about this? Another good player from the outside. Nice move, gets the sack on Kyle Bowler. And then Teddy Bruschi also.
Chester Taylor into the secondary and hit by Randall Gay and Rodney Harrison for seven yards.
And just to finish up, Teddy Bruschi from the outside. What a nice move on Chester Taylor. Comes right around and causes a fumble and gives Jarvis Green a touchdown. There's Romeo Crennel, the defensive coordinator.
You think he likes these numbers?
Oh.
Very hot candidate when it comes to talking about.
Oh, yeah, but, yeah, head coach, yeah, I know. Mm-hmm. Yeah, don't anybody hire Romeo Crennel and Charlie Weiss, no.
But these guys, their season gets so extended that they get left behind. Bowler picks up the first down, just their second of the half. That to Kevin Johnson.
You know, I think, too, as we talk about the Patriots, the fact that they play so many guys, it keeps you fresh. It keeps you motivated because you better keep playing well. Somebody will take your job. And like you talked about earlier, it keeps them lively. And look at the offensive line on the sideline. No helmets on. Just Dante Scarnecchia, the coach, right in the middle of them. Time to have a good laugh.
Inside of 6 minutes to go. First down for the Ravens. And that pass, one hop to Wilcox. You know, you look at the playoff picture in the AFC at this point as we approach December. Pittsburgh at 10-1. And remember, they've already beaten the Patriots. New England's going to be 10-1. They had that, talking about New England, that 21-game win streak until they ran into a steel barrier on Halloween Day. San Diego improves to 8-3. And the Colts have a 2-game lead now as Jacksonville fell today. Got Denver playing tonight. And Baltimore about to drop back to 7-4.
For the AFC, it is tough. Oh,
look out, over the head of Bowler, into the end zone. Vrabel chases him, and somehow he's able to just get it away.
That was some play by Kyle Bowler.
Wow. Robach, the center.
Jim, you can just tell. Look how muddy. Look at the mud that was on the football as they came back. It's soaking wet. Oh, gosh. Oh, yeah. Hey, wait, what was that again?
This is football weather.
That's yeah, right. Okay, yeah. Hey, won't you go play golf when it's snowing outside and on the ground?
Hey, I didn't say that.
Oh, okay. I like people when all this they say
I have to say, I am enjoying it. Well, now they have to call a timeout here. As the down clock was about to expire. You saw the AFC playoff picture. And again, everybody's been talking about how you could be 10-6 this year in the AFC and be left on the sidelines come playoff time. But then you look over in the NFC and the Eagles are already in. They clinched their division today. Atlanta with a late touchdown, a touchdown pass by Vic. That game is just going final. We'll be 9-2.
Look at that.
Minnesota 7-4. Seattle getting slammed today.
Look at the record, though. Seattle's going to lose. They're going to be 6-5. St. Louis 5-5. And you've got seven losses in the NFC. You go, heck, we're right in the middle of it.
I get back, though, on the AFC side to what we were talking about with the Colts on Thursday. You know, they're still sitting 2 games back of both the Steelers and the Patriots, which means they're going to have to win on the road as they got another Keystone Kop play, and it's finally secured at the 11-yard line.
Hey, it's getting to a point right now. If you're the Baltimore Ravens, if you do get the football back, you just run it. Get the game over with, because you're putting at risk your starting quarterback and other players. Oh, boy. Robach just, he hesitates on the snap. Watch him pull it up. Oh, take it. Oh, that is tough. Of course, he's getting all kinds of different looks up front. It's not funny. It's tough. Playing a good football team, you do the best you can.
Murphy boots it away to Troy Brown. Brown splashing around to the 47.
Baltimore Ravens making some substitutions on defense, taking a few of their frontline starters out. Fatigue, and they know the game is over.
Patrick pass in the late going with the flag down. You know, talking to Brian Billick yesterday, I got such a kick out of hearing him talk about how often people come up to him thinking he's Bill Belichick.
Holding offense, number 88, 10-yard penalty. Still first down.
I said, how often does that happen? He says, like, every time I go out, people say, hey, Bill, how you doing? Well, I don't know. I'll see him next month. I'll ask him.
But he told the story, and, of course, his daughter, we were out to dinner one night recently, and they came up and said, Coach Belichick, congratulations. And, of course, his daughter, they love it because Dad's high and almighty, puts him back in his place. And he took a little solace in the fact that a few weeks ago the Patriots were in St. Louis, and Bill Belichick was introduced as Bill, no.
No, as Brian Belichick.
Brian Belichick.
That's what it was.
Bill Belichick. Yeah.
Somewhere.
You got me.
Screw a story. But you get the idea.
Yeah.
So does everybody else. About those two. Kevin Faulk with his first carry of the game. 4.5 remaining. And I'd like to welcome those of you who saw the Jets beat the Arizona Cardinals with that Quincy Carter long touchdown pass to Santana Moss. And the Jets improved to 8-3, winning back-to-back road games at Cleveland and Arizona.
You know, and everybody, of course, I live in New York, and in New York area, I hear it. The Jets, Chad Pennington, their starting quarterback, goes down. They've won 2 of 3, and they lost a tremendously tough game against this Baltimore Ravens team. So look where they are.
Herman Edwards has been telling us this season, when we've been around him, it's always a race to 10 for the playoffs. Ed Reed with a tackle behind a line of scrimmage, although the AFC this year might be more than that necessary. Now, back to this Belichick and Billick confusion. Brian Billick ordered some suits in the offseason. Beautiful suits from custom suit maker who goes around, apparently does a lot of business with coaches. NFL coaches. He got the shipment in. He put on the first suit and it came up to about his elbows, and he looked inside, and there it had it all stitched inside, and it said,
Bill Belichick.
Bill Belichick.
He goes, oh, come on. So it was pretty good stuff. And, you know, Brian Billick, pretty good sport about all of it. He gets a big kick out of it. And this laughs and takes it the right way.
Patrick pass backed up at the 40.
Well, you know, I can relate to that, Jim. I can.
You get
I get hey, Boomer, all the time.
You mean you're not?
No, I'm not. I have comments about it. I won't say I'm here on the air. Boomer gets it too, but
yes, he does. I can verify that.
Look at that. Just the uniforms, the mud in the middle of the field. Wow, it's bad.
What does a game like this do to the psyche of the Ravens, who came in having won 5 of the last 6?
Proud of what they were.
Absolutely, and knowing that there's a very high probability they may have to meet again up here.
Here's what it will do. It won't deter the way they think. You know what they're going to say? Hey, all right, we learned what it's going to take. We know now we're going to toughen up. We'll get better. And if the opportunity comes again, we'll rectify the situation.
One thing about the Patriots, if you look at their schedule the rest of the way, in their last 5 games, they have only one game against a team currently with a winning record, and that's at the New York Jets the day after Christmas. The rest, they got Miami that came into the weekend with one win, San Francisco that stuck on one win,
Well, that's why Brian Billick.
Next week. Yep.
That's why Brian Billick looked at him and he goes, come on, who are you kidding? Patriots will fall apart and they're still going to have a tremendous record. Look at that schedule that's left for the New England Patriots.
At Cleveland next week on a CBS game at 1 o'clock, many of you will see. And then 2 weeks to get the field fixed for Cincinnati coming in here on the 12th. There's Bowler over to Chester Taylor. For a gain of about 7, and Troy Brown is in on defense making the play. Man, we're reaching the 2-minute warning, and the Ravens got stuck in the mud today. Patriots have just absolutely owned the second half on their way to 10-1. New England 24 and Baltimore 3. We'd like to welcome those of you who saw the Buffalo Bills improve their record to 5-6 by manhandling the Seahawks out in Seattle today. And here's what we've seen with the rain falling all day. Corey Dillon with another 100-yard performance.
Corey Dillon was so strong along with the offensive line. And Adam Vinatieri, Mr. Clutch, coming through early in the game when the Patriots really needed it. And then the defense took over for the Patriots. Teddy Bruschi causes a fumble. Jarvis Green recovers it for a touchdown.
Final 2 minutes, 2nd and 2, and that ball snagged by the rookie, Clarence Moore. Clarence Moore taken this past spring in the 6th round out of Northern Arizona. We saw him catch 2 touchdowns at the New York Jets just 2 weeks ago. What a prospect he is at 6'6". Bowler. Warren giving chase, now Banta Kane and down the field and over the head of Kevin Johnson. Let's send it back to Greg Gumbel for an update.
All right, Jim, in Atlanta, the New Orleans Saints at Tampa next week, guys.
How about that? Thank you, Greg. We've got 2 divisions locked up now in the NFC with the Eagles also claiming one earlier today, claiming the NFC East with a win over the Giants. Kevin Johnson, ridden down by Earth, Wind, Moreland. You're wondering about that name, Earth, Wind. If it sounds familiar, yes, his mother named him after her favorite band, Earth, Wind, and Fire.
Fire,
yes. Good band. Loved it.
Slopping around Bowler with a flag down in the area of offensive holding.
Well, you can hear the water and mud as the play takes off.
Holding. Offense. Number 75. 10 yards penalty. Still 3rd down.
Look at all that mud. Look at it being kicked up. And, you know, if I was like somewhere between 4 years old and 12 years old, this would be one heck of a day right now. I'd be out there having a lot of fun. Kyle Bowler running. Oh, man, that's a little kid's dream to run down. I saw one of the players get blocked a minute ago by the Baltimore Ravens, and no exaggeration, he slid 10 yards right in the middle of that field. And I know he got up and went, well, that was a sensation he probably hadn't had in a long time.
How many games did you play in conditions that deteriorated this much?
Well, you know, Jim, I played at Gillette Stadium, so I played on AstroTurf my whole career.
How about on the road, though?
No, I never really played in a game that got like this. Not one.
Airing it out for Clarence Moore. Oh, and he should have had it.
Perfect throw by Kyle Bowler.
I mentioned Clarence Moore was drafted in the 6th round. He was the 199th pick in this year's draft. And if you look back at that exact number in the 2000 draft, Tom Brady was the 6th round pick of the Patriots, picked with the 199th selection. We can only hope, if you're a Raven fan, that Clarence Moore ends up having anywhere close to what this man's career has been like already in just 5 years. I'd like to welcome those of you who saw the Miami Dolphins collect their 2nd win of the year. Dexter Reed almost making a pick to officially close things out, but they'll get it back on downs as the Ravens have been shut down in the 2nd half. In the AFC East, The New England Patriots 10-1 on their way to 10-1 here, 48 seconds from official. The Jets win out in the desert today against Arizona. Big matchup still looming for those two on December 26th at Giant Stadium when the Jets will host the Patriots. Buffalo improves to 5-6 and the Dolphins at 2-9.
Yeah, the Jets are just hoping that the Patriots could slip up one time so they could play that game and have a chance to tie them up if they could continue to win out.
Rohan Davey with a kneel down, the backup quarterback. Teddy Bruschi forced a fumble that was recovered for a touchdown by Jarvis Green. Corey Dillon went over 100 yards, and the Patriots have the upper hand today in a very big way. Baltimore with 29 total yards this half and only 3 first downs. Not necessary to snap it another time. That'll do it. Baltimore falls to 7-4 and 3 games back of the Steelers in the AFC North, while the Patriots are 10-1, joining Pittsburgh and Philadelphia with the best record in football. For Phil Simms, Bonnie Bernstein, and the entire crew back in the studio in New York, well done back there today as well. Jim Nantz saying so long from Foxborough, where the Patriots have beaten the Baltimore Ravens 24-3. You've been watching the NFL on CBS.